Hey boys, John Kerry, 1963 Jag. Still working on these interior parts. So I just did a little rabble bomb this afternoon. I had put some etch primer on them before I went on my last business trip, and so now I'm just knocking out a little black rust-proofing Krylon stuff to just put on something on it underneath the upholstery and the glue and all that jazzmatazz. So I'm just documenting that I'm going through everything nice and carefully, cleaning it up, putting it back together. So that's what's going on here. Check out this gorgeous sunshine day, guys. I know it's still cold back east a little bit, but I feel bad for you. Sorry about that. But we're just full on into springtime / summertime out here right now. I mean, look at these geraniums. They look like they look almost like psychedelic color. And the roses are happy. My lemon tree's looking better. I was worried about it this winter. Really struggled, but it looks like it's coming back. I had to cut back a lot of dead wood. I'll have to do a little more now, I can see. But that's all right. And then, I don't know if I've been telling you guys, but we've been remodeling the house. I think I told you this was all full of furniture, so that's been moved out. There's just a couple of little scraps left here and there, and the few cartons that we have some small pieces in, and some moving blankets got to be put away. But other than that, the garage is sort of starting to come back together. Denise will be able to put her car away. I'm sure she'll be happy about that. Hang on one sec. Can't play copyrighted music. Don't ask me why. It's on the radio for free, but you can't rebroadcast it on YouTube. So just kind of getting my shit together for what I need to do with regard to the upholstery work, and I wanted to show you guys the adhesives that I'm talking about when I posted on my internet. So there's a 3M high strength number 90 spray adhesive and 3M rubber and vinyl adhesive number 80 in the spray cans, and then this stuff down here, which I was recommended to get. Hold on, there's too much glare. I was recommended to get this stuff for doing a headliner, and it's called Super Weather Strip and Gasket Adhesive, yellow, 3M. And then it says Stage 2, whatever that means. And the part number, as you can see here, is, maybe you can't, it's 08001. So that's kind of what that's enough. And then I've got some what used to be MEK, toluene, xylene stuff, what was poison. So they've come out with a new one that's not so bad for your skin, but it will dissolve glue. And I got a little Weiss and Grax remover. I love that, Weiss and Grax. Grease and wax remover, just to have a little something around the house for when I'm prepping and getting ready to do stuff. And then I don't know if I ever told you guys, but I bought a bottle of this spray-on stuff that's anti-rust spray, and it's like body wax, and it comes with a little spray tube and a little nozzle. And this is another 3M part number 08892. So that's my supply of goodies. I got a little latex paint there right now. I just was doing a little honeydew stuff. The house has just been nonstop, so the car has suffered. Here it sits covered up with nothing going on right now. But I'll get these foam units back together as soon as I can, and then start covering up some of these other sheet metal pieces and such. But the dealio with the house is that we had the floors replaced. And when the floors got replaced, the baseboards had to get ripped off. And when the baseboards get ripped off, they all have to be repainted, renailed, reputted, repainted, caulked along the edges, etc., etc. And this is just a consequence of some of that. These are some little thin shelving things that you put on the wall to put pictures on and stuff, and that was in one of the bedrooms that got painted, and I had to redo the walls. Or sorry, they got the new floor. We had to do new wall paint because it was all banged up and wrecked from where they took the moldings off. So man, this just expanded and expanded. It's just become a lot more work than I think Denise and I ever expected it to be. But I'm gonna get back on the car. This is Easter weekend, so I'll probably have a little time off, which will be good. Oh, I forgot to bring my stickers out. Shoot. I have Grim Reaper and Somebody else, I can't remember. I got another one just the other day. I'll bring them out here and do a video on those. So, hope everybody's doing good. I saw Darren was in the hospital. That's a drag, and I hope he feels better. I haven't had a chance to catch up on videos. I thought I'd just come out here and say hi and let you guys know that I'm home, back at it, you know, trying to, I don't know, do whatever I can do. It's kind of going to be a bit challenging to get a lot done on the car right now because of the housework, but I'm working on it. I'll get there. We'll get there, you know. So, watching everybody's videos. I was over in Europe, so I was watching videos while I was over there because I was alone in a hotel room over the weekend. My trip lasted over a weekend, so it was nice to be able to check in on everybody. All right, so I'll put some more onto this. Maybe I'll pen something to it over the weekend, and this will be a nice hot, you know, video showing some progress. Take care, guys.
Hey guys, John Kerry, 1963 Jag. Mentioned I was going to start working on the interior, so here you see the dashboard cover laying upside down with the vent hoses coming out and such, but I'm putting the new cover on that, and so I've started gluing from the center, which was straight and easy, and then started working my way around these curvy parts. So I did the back with clips. So these little spring clips that push in here, there's one, there isn't one there, but I think I need one. Oh, there's one, so on and so on. So clips all the way across the back, which sort of anchored it, and then I've been pulling it and gluing it across the front here. So sorry for the shaky cam, sort of gluing it in across the front. So some of the curves kind of, you know, a little more difficult to do, so I decided I'll just get the flat part in the middle here. This is just a protective strip, but I cut some feathers here to do that curve, but I haven't gotten that done yet, and then I got to cut these over here to allow it to go around that curve. And the same thing will happen on this side. I've got just the raw plastic here. You can see the raw vinyl, so I haven't even started to cut this side up. I'm just working my way around that corner over there. So, little by little, the other thing I did the other day is I put some black paint on these are the stone guards, splash guards that go on the bottom of the engine compartment. So that's one, two, and then I also threw a little black on these trim pieces. I saw that I took a little video of that. So here they are hanging up now. They're dry. So I can begin gluing the foams back onto those and then think about stretching the leather. the vinyl over the top of those. So anyway, starting to make some progress. It's kind of fun to be working on things that are going to make the car look pretty. So that's exciting. What a gorgeous day we had today. So another beautiful day. What do I got here? 4 o'clock? No, it's four. No, it's five. Almost 5 o'clock, and we're shooting at a, what are we looking at there? About 80 degrees, I think. Yeah. About 80 degrees, pretty nice outside. It's beautiful, sunshine out there. My camera's going to have to adjust its white balance because it's so bright. But a really beautiful day, so 80 degrees. Nice. There we go. It's definitely clear. Sunshine, a little hazy, a little bit of high cloud. Here and there, that's keeping the temperature down a little bit. It looks a little more cloudy back in that direction. That's to the southeast. South is sort of in that direction there. And we're looking west. And that way to the north. It looks okay. So, yeah. I'll append this to one of my other videos and hopefully make some progress so you guys can see that I'm getting there. Okay, take care. Bye. Okay, these are the trim pieces that go under the windows. So I stripped and cleaned and painted the metal underpiece. And then I stripped the adhesive off the back of the foam rubber with a razor blade. And then I've just sprayed on some 3M high strength number 90. And I'm just waiting for it to get tacky, and then I'll attach the foam rubber to the metal. This is in preparation to getting ready to cover them with foam, with vinyl, I mean. And then the next ones I'll put the foam on are these big long ones you see here. So I'll put those foam pieces that are back there onto these. So stay tuned. I'll bring you back when I get some more done.
Okay.